Oh, as soon as a vehicle leaves a repair facility, it's under attack.
Corrosion starts to form immediately. Corrosion starts immediately.
As soon as a panel gets exposed to the atmosphere.
The corrosion's going to start as soon as the repair occurs, probably when the accident occurs.
There's just no going back. Once it starts, it just progresses.
I use Buffalo, New York as the example. That's the benchmark for the worst place to be a car. Instead of sodium chloride, I believe they're using magnesium chloride, which may be more corrosive.
There's no bigger threat to the body structure of a vehicle than an improperly done body repair.
It's not just what you see that causes corrosion. There's the hidden damage of a collision that needs to be addressed as well.
The customer doesn't see the internal cavity wax corrosion protection, but I will tell you that when you look at the value of the vehicle and its the longevity of the repair, it's very critical to that, to provide protection where they don't see it.
Quite frankly, today's customer, if they're paying attention at all, is a consumer that fully expects that car to perform just like it did originally in the event that they're in another accident. Out of sight is not out of mind, and everyone's going to see the backside of the repair in a couple of years, especially if you're in a high corrosion area, and they're going to see it through a rust hole.
The repair shop is under an obligation to restore that vehicle to that level of corrosion protection and strength and structural integrity that was there when the car was built by the factory.
If we make a repair, a sectioning joint that's condoned by the engineers, and we don't address the inside of that joint, and we leave the opportunity for premature corrosion to begin, which in some areas of the country can happen by the end of the week, then what we've done is we've begun to have a car on our hands that is severely compromised in its ability to perform properly in the event that it's in another accident. And if it doesn't perform properly, then it may not fold up the way it's designed to fold up. It certainly might not respond in a way that the airbags are going to recognize properly, and deployment might not come off the way it was intended. The ability to walk away, if you will, undamaged or uninjured from a vehicle accident is much greater today than it's ever been. The role the collision industry has in that is that when we do repair these vehicles, we've got to be able to let that car go back to the customer knowing that it's going to perform the same way against corrosion that it did when it was first built.